Mike Radich here, and I'm now joined on the phone by MMA up-and-comer Sarah McLeod. Sarah, how are you?
I'm good, thank you. How are you?
I'm doing good. Sarah, you got a fight coming up this Friday at Fight to Win. I don't even know what number it is, but yeah, you're fighting for a Colorado-based promotion. It's this Friday. It feels weird saying a fight on Friday. Usually Saturday is, you know, fight night. Does it feel weird fighting on a Friday?
It does, actually. I've been thinking about it all this week. I guess it didn't really kind of affect me or come into play until the weight cut, and I usually, you know, plan my fights accordingly, and usually everything's set up for weigh-ins on Friday. So, I mean, there's a little bit of change in my dieting, but that's about all. Mm-hmm. But it definitely is different.
Mm-hmm. Since this is a fight week, I'm just curious, what's your schedule like from now until the fight?
Well, I've cleared my schedule for my weight-cutting week, and my training pretty much consists of training in the morning and training at night. Nighttime is always just cardio, as I've got to get the last couple pounds off, and this morning was my kind of my last day of just light pad work, but yeah, that's about it. It's kind of just running from here on out, just light cardio until I make that weight.
Mm-hmm. Now, are you flying to Colorado, or are you making the drive for the fight?
I'll be flying.
Okay. I was just curious about that, because I think it's like a six-hour drive or something like that, and I'm like, that's kind of rough.
And when you're cutting weight, too, yeah. That's a very difficult drive to do, so I'm very thankful that the promotion pays for the flight. Also, I'm not sure that I'll be able to take it.
Yeah, that's good. Now, I'm just curious, do you have any pre-fight rituals or any sort of superstitions before you fight? Anything that you have to do before the fight, whether it's something you have to eat or something, you know, maybe a movie you have to watch, a song you have to listen to? Is there anything like that?
Let's see. Well, before I fight, I love to have an energy drink. So in the back room, I'm always sipping an energy drink because you never really know when your name's going to be called. So sometimes you can be sitting in the back for 3+ hours waiting for all the fights before you to finish. So I like to have that energy drink, kind of just sipping on it and keeping my energy levels up high, especially since you could be in the back room until 10 p.m. at night, so you never really know. And as for anything else, I really just love to go in calm and relax. I don't warm up in the back room. I just stretch. I might do some light shadow boxing, but I really don't like to warm up because then I feel that my heart rate gets going, and I kind of get anxious then if I warm up. So I like to go in calm and relaxed, and that seems to work out perfectly for me.
I see. Now, I'm just curious, since this is a fight week, when do you start to get your game face on? Is it when you get the offer for a fight? Is it when you arrive in the city that you're fighting in? Is it when you weigh in? Is it when you arrive to the venue for the fight? Is it when you're warming up backstage? Is it when you're walking out? You know, when exactly do you start to get your game face on?
Well, I mean, I'm always training consistently anyway, so I guess mm-hmm. when I find out that I actually have an opponent and the contract signed, then the intensity kind of increases a bit more, and it's always nice to kind of visualize a face in front of you when you're with your sparring partners, and I've kind of always been visualizing now my opponent. So I think that helps my mental game a lot. But as for my game face, it really doesn't come on until, you know, she hits me with the first punch, and then it's on.
I see.
I guess when I get punched, then my game face goes on.
Right. So you're saying if you never get punched, your game face never comes on?
Yeah, I guess if I never get punched, then I'm pretty happy-go-lucky, calm and relaxed. But, you know, when I get punched in the face, you're against somebody that I wouldn't want to be against.
I see. Now, you're taking on Heather Denny. How much do you know about her?
I've done as much research as I can on her, and I know she's got a very good record as an amateur. I believe she was 7-2 against a lot of legit opponents, and she's making her pro debut at 115 pounds. She's always fought at 25. I believe the lowest that she's gone is 120. So this will be her first cut to 115, and she's a very tough girl. From what I can see, she's mostly stand-up. She likes to stand and brawl. And, she's really lengthy, kind of the same body type as me, so it could be a striker match, but I'm sure she's prepared just as much as I have her wrestling game and jiu-jitsu game to come in as a very overall, well-rounded fighter.
Mm-hmm. Now, Heather Denny, she's the hometown girl. You're going into enemy territory. Do you like kind of playing that villain role coming into this fight? You know, obviously you're going to her hometown to spoil the party and pick up a win. Do you like playing that role?
Definitely. I often get asked this when I fight out of town, and I actually prefer fighting out of town. I feel that it's easier for me to kind of get that killer instinct out in me. Naturally, I'm not a very, you know, aggressive or, I mean, I don't want to say mean, but I don't have that kind of attitude naturally. And, you know, it really comes out in me when it's an out-of-town fight, whereas when I'm at home, I feel way too comfortable. I feel like I have all my loved ones around me, and, you know, they don't expect anything. They just want me to do my best. And I think the killer instinct comes out in me a lot easier when I'm away from home.
Now, during this training camp, have you done anything special to deal with the altitude that you're going to have to deal with when August 15th rolls around? Have you done anything special during this training camp to deal with the altitude?
I've pretty much focused just on completing longer rounds of sparring and also higher intensity cardio. And I switched my strength and conditioning gym to a gym that is very humid. So I feel like that'll help my breathing. But, I mean, other than that, it's just higher intensity cardio for longer periods. And I've added in swimming, I guess, so maybe that'll help out too.
Now, last time out, you made your pro debut. You won the fight by second round submission via rear naked choke. Talk to me a little bit about that fight. You know, how was it your first time stepping in as a professional? Was it, you know, the same old, you know, longer rounds, but did the fight feel any different? Obviously, you're in the professional ranks now. Did it feel different, or was it just kind of the same deal?
As for, you know, differences, I really only noticed, obviously, the time was the only really real difference. I do prefer 5-minute rounds. I feel that 3-minute rounds is kind of too short, and maybe at the 3-minute mark, you're kind of just getting your position or just finding your range. So I really enjoyed the 5-minute rounds, and I guess that was the only difference.
Now, I'm just curious, because you had a long layoff. You fought in August of 2012. This is during your amateur days. You fought in August of 2012, and then you didn't fight until March of 2014. And if I got the story straight, it was because of school. That was the reason why you had this layoff. Was there any injuries involved as well?
Yeah, it was the main reason was actually I had a back injury. Okay. I was training at the gym, and I was doing my deadlift PR, and something just snapped in my back, and we never could really figure out what went wrong with it. And I just took that time off to kind of recover. The main reason was an injury. But I mean, it helped my school. I'm always doing school full time, so I just had to focus more on school during my injury recovery.
Right. Right. Now, you kind of disappeared, because I follow you on Facebook, and, you know, you were updating all the time, and then there was like a 6 or 8 month period. I mean, I don't know the exact amount of months that went by, but there was a long time where there hadn't been any word from you. You hadn't posted anything. You know, there was no fight scheduled. There was nothing. Where did you go during that time? Why wasn't there any updates?
Well, I mean, being so active in the mixed martial arts community, it was something that I really lived for. That was a huge part of my life. And when I got injured, it was very devastating to me. I didn't know if my back was going to get better. And I saw so many doctors, and nobody had an answer for me. So it was kind of a stage that I just kind of, just put social media off for a while to kind of just focus on myself. And, you know, I just wanted to make sure that I came back to social media with a positive mind and, you know, figure out what I was going to do from there.
I see. Because I was always curious about what happened. And then one day you just magically popped up, and it was like you never left. So I was curious about that. So you returned at VFC 42, a very good card, a stack from top to bottom. Victory does a great job with their shows. They're always fun. You fought a very tough fight. It was against Rebecca Wells. You won the fight by unanimous decision. Talk to me about that fight. How was that? You know, you hadn't fought in a very long time. It was a very tough fight. Overall, how do you think you did in that one?
I believe it wasn't one of my best performances, and I did kind of feel the cage rest. But it was a good experience for me that I still had, you know, the desire to do well, the desire to compete, and you know, after that competition, I just kind of felt a lot more training and focus on, you know, kind of my post recovery training, I felt that I would be prepared for the next time out. But it was kind of just a feel out to future that I'm back to injury. And, you know, everything came out okay.
Now, I'm just curious, where did you get your nickname, TNT?
I don't really remember if there was a specific person. I remember I made, like, a Facebook, and then all of a sudden people started calling me Dynamite and TNT and all sorts of things, like, with explosives, according to my punches. Because when I first got in the cage, pretty much all I had was punches. And to this day, I mean, punching is stand-up with my punches are my strength. So the name just kind of came out from there.
I see. Now, I'm just curious, the upcoming season of The Ultimate Fighter, Tough 20, that season is going to feature all 115-pound women, and strawweight, 115 pounds, is the weight class that you fight in. So I'm just curious, why didn't you try out for The Ultimate Fighter?
Before I was a professional was when the Tough tryouts went on. I was actually 0-0 as a professional. I hadn't had any competitions yet, and the requirements to try out was to have at least one professional fight. So I was unable to try out.
I see. And I'm just curious, there's a lot of good organizations out there that feature strawweight women. You have Invicta, you have XFC, you have World Series of Fighting, all these bigger shows that are really, really behind women's MMA. I'm just curious, have any of them reached out to you?
No, not those ones that you named. I do have a lot of offers that I've received actually going into this next fight that I have, and I've told everyone that I can't commit to anything until, you know, after this fight, after I hear from school. But I do have a lot of offers for a lot of big names, so I believe this fight will bring me a lot of opportunities.
Oh, I see. Well, Sarah, real quick before I let you go, do you have any sponsors you'd like to thank, and is there anything you'd like to say to the fans?
Yeah, I do want to thank my sponsors. I have a lot of support going into this next fight. First of all, I have Chic Clothing. You can find them at chicfighter.com, and that's spelled C-I-C-C-H-I-C. I also have a protein sponsor called Natural Grade Nutrition, who's definitely been helping me get the lowest body fat possible for this fight, which helps me, of course, make weight. I also want to thank Jason Adams that are promoting Real Women Radio. And, of course, just anyone who sends me positive energy. I love all my fans, friends, family.
Sarah, thank you for taking the time to talk. I really appreciate it, and best of luck coming up on Friday night.
Thank you so much, Mike.